ordinary table salt is a substance you're probably very familiar with. The chemical name for table salt is sodium chloride. Its chemical formula is NaCl. We know that table salt contains the elements sodium and chlorine. But in what form? And what forces hold them together to make up the structure we call table salt? Rather than sodium atoms and chlorine atoms, sodium chloride is made up of sodium ions and chloride ions. Ions are electrically charged particles. Sodium atoms donate an electron to become sodium ions. Chlorine atoms accept an electron to become chloride ions. But what makes sodium atoms want to donate an electron to become positively charged? And why does chlorine accept an electron to become negatively charged? Let's answer that question so we can better understand what holds these ions together in the compound. We'll need to review the electron configurations of the sodium and chlorine atoms to see how the sodium ions and chloride ions are formed. Sodium has 11 electrons, one more than neon, so we can write its electron configuration as neon 3s1 using the nearest noble gas notation. Chlorine has 17 electrons, or 7 more than neon. Two of these fill the 3s atomic orbital, and the remaining 5 partially fill the 3p atomic orbital. This means that sodium has 1 valence electron and chlorine has 7 valence electrons. First, let's write the Lewis dot structure for each atom. We only have to worry about the electrons in the valence shell, since we know that these are the ones that react. We put one dot next to the symbol for sodium. We put 7 dots around the symbol for chlorine. We can use the Lewis electron dot notation for the sodium and chlorine atoms to see how the ions are formed. Sodium's single valence electron is transferred to the chlorine. The products of this reaction are a sodium ion and a chloride ion. The sodium ion has one less electron than the sodium atom, so it has a net positive 1 charge. The chloride ion has one more electron than the chlorine atom, so it has a net negative 1 charge. We can also see this process using electron configurations. Sodium readily donates its single 3s electron to chlorine. This gives the sodium ion the same electron configuration as neon. The chloride ion now has 8 more electrons than neon. Now we've reviewed the material that will help us answer the question, what holds the sodium and chloride ions together in table salt? Neutral sodium atoms and chlorine atoms don't combine to form sodium chloride under normal circumstances. It's only when sodium donates an electron to chlorine, giving us sodium ions and chloride ions, that we get sodium chloride. There must be some kind of attraction between the positive and negative ions. This electrostatic attraction between positive and negative ions is called an ionic bond. Now we're ready to figure out how ionic bonds are different from covalent bonds. The basic difference between ionic and covalent bonds is that electrons are transferred from one atom to another in an ionic bond, but in a covalent bond, two atoms share one or more pairs of electrons. Let's look at two compounds to better understand this important difference. As we've just seen, in the ionic compound, sodium chloride, an electron from sodium is transferred to chlorine to produce the sodium and chloride ions. Chlorine can also form covalent bonds. Two chlorine atoms, having 7 valence electrons apiece, each donate 1 electron to form a pair of electrons shared by the two atoms. This shared pair of electrons is called a covalent bond. We can use the periodic table to predict the kind of bonding we might expect in a compound. The elements shown in turquoise are the metals. The elements shown in gray are the metalloids. And the elements shown in green are the nonmetals. We've seen compounds that contain the nonmetal chlorine. Sodium chloride contains bonds between sodium ions and chloride ions. A bond between a metal and a nonmetal is usually ionic. When chlorine forms a bond with another nonmetal, the bond is usually covalent. In the chlorine molecule, the bond between the two chlorine atoms is pure covalent because the electronegativity difference is zero. Chlorine also forms bonds with nonmetals other than itself. Carbon tetrachloride contains four chlorine atoms, each bonded to a central carbon. Carbon and chlorine are both nonmetals, and they form a covalent bond. Chlorine is more electronegative than carbon, so the carbon-chlorine bonds are polar covalent. Let's summarize what we've learned. A bond between a metal and a nonmetal is usually ionic. A bond between two nonmetals can be pure covalent or polar covalent, depending on the electronegativity of the atoms.